Anybody who sniffs hair for a living is a little weird to me.
...2020 Democrats, who stands out, if anyone?
Crazy Bernie with the giant patch on his head from hitting his head on the shower door.
When you are a billionaire, you may not understand what it is like to be in a family that lives paycheck to paycheck.
Beto O'Rourke.
You mean Robert Francis O'Rourke, the guy who's a disservice to the Irish Catholic that, you know, I am part of.
All right, everybody share this. Beto O'Rourke is on a skateboard in a Whataburger parking lot.
Do you think Hillary Clinton's gonna jump into the race?
I think she wants to. Oh, she wants to so badly, right? I think if she could, she would. I think she's still heavily medicated from the last election loss, though.
What do you think she's doing now, by the way?
Heavily medicated from the last election loss, I think, is what she's still doing. She's trying to find Wisconsin on a map because I think the Russians hid it from her.
Everyone's favorite Congresswoman, Ocasio-Cortez.
Look, she does a disservice to higher education. I think she went to Boston University, which I used to think was a good school.
Look at these figures and we say, oh, unemployment is low, everything is fine, right? Well, unemployment is low because everyone has two jobs. Unemployment is low because people are working 60, 70, 80 hours a week.
If she's not the stupidest person in Congress, and maybe she, you know, it's a close race because you're talking about a lot of stupid people, she's very close to the top of the list.
President Donald Trump.
Winner, love him.
We're gonna win, win, win. It's what we're doing.
What did you think of Jesse Smollett and him allegedly staging a hate hoax against himself?
You mean when he claimed that two white guys who were wearing Make America Great Again hats at 3 o'clock in the morning at 20 below attacked him, and then it was two, you know, African-American guys that he paid to do the deal and get off of it? The whole thing's a scam. I hope the Department of Justice investigates him and he ends up in jail, because if it were me or you, that's where we'd be.
Your thoughts on the media today?
Oh, they're the most dishonest people I've ever seen. You know, when these guys say they never get anything wrong, they're, you know, unapologetic. It's so embarrassing to be a member of the media these days that people should actually go become trash collectors, because it's a much more honorable profession.
What did you make of Governor Ralph Northam and his whole blackface and KKK yearbook scandal?
This is amazing. Not only did he not admit that he was either in blackface or he was in the Ku Klux Klan outfit, and he didn't discern which one it was, then he wanted to do the moonwalk to prove that, you know, who he was. And the only reason this guy didn't get thrown out of office is because the lieutenant governor and the attorney general were doing some crazy shit too. And so it's amazing. If that was a Republican, these guys would have been thrown out on their ears, but no one's even talking about it anymore. And he's on a listening tour and it's just a disaster.
The Mueller probe.
Look, I'm glad it's over. It was the greatest witch hunt ever perpetrated by the American, you know, on an American president or the American people. It was the closest thing ever to a coup to get someone who's a duly elected president out of office. And the great news is Donald Trump, his family, our campaign team, 100% vindication. No Russians on the campaign, no white Russian drinks on the campaign, no Russian dressing on the campaign.